So let's see how we can use technology in order to find what happens as h gets really small. So what we're going to do is we're going to put this in as a graph. We're going to put that difference quotient in. So go to our y equals. And now we're going to need an extra set of parentheses because the whole numerator will have to be in a set of parentheses. Other than that, we can put it in pretty much how we have it. So we have a 2 plus. Now we don't have an h. So we are going to have to use x to be our h. And then that part is getting cubed. And then we have minus 2 times 2 plus x, or that's our h. Now we also have a minus 4 to end the numerator and divided by x. Now because we're doing this in the calculator, that's why we didn't have to simplify it. What we're going to find in the next section is when we want to do it algebraically, that we will have to simplify that. But if we're using our calculator to help us out, we don't need to. We can put it in pretty much exactly how we wrote it. All right. Now, what we're going to do, we could graph this and look, but we don't need to. What we're going to do is we're going to go and use the table. So this table right here. So we're going to go to second table set, because we want to have our table set a certain way. Doesn't really matter where it starts or what the change in the table value is, but we want to change this to be on ask. So we want the independent to be on ask. We want the dependent to be on auto. Alright, now we're going to go over to our table. So we do second table. Accidentally went to the graph there. So we do second table. And now, basically, with this, we can add in our h values to see what happens as h gets really small. So what we're going to do, maybe we put in 1, so the average rate of change is 17. Maybe we put in half, so the average rate of change between 2 and 2.5 is 13.25. Maybe we put in a quarter, so the average rate of change between 2 and 2.25 is 11.6563. Now, sometimes these will be rounded off. If you put the cursor on there, you get all the decimal places, all the way up to here. And so we can start seeing what happens is the h gets smaller and smaller. So, we want to know what happens as h gets to be close to 0. Well, if we actually put in 0, we get an error, because if you remember our expression, divided by our x, or our h, so putting in 0 means we're dividing by a denominator of 0. So, we can't put in 0. We can put in values that get really close to it. So maybe 0.01, 0.001. Notice these are all yielding an output. So where does it look like our average rate of change is heading towards? Again, if we move the cursor over, we get more decimal places, but look at that. What we're seeing is it's just adding another 0 in there every time we put in another decimal point place. So it looks like we're going to have an instantaneous rate of change of 10 at 2. And that's how we can use technology in order to find that.